Welcome to Java FRM. Now we are going to see how to manually configure a virtual hard drive in Ubuntu 14.04 update 5. Now I am going to create a Ubuntu 14.04 desktop virtual machine. Here I am going to allocate 16 GB to my virtual machine. Next, I am going to allocate hard drive, which is a dynamically allocated hard drive, size of 160 GB. Make sure that you have enough space in your hard disk to allocate the virtual hard drive with huge space. So right click settings. So I am enabling my clipboard now. So processor, I am allocating 6-core processor to this Ubuntu desktop virtual machine. So on the storage, I am going to select Ubuntu 14.04 update 5 installation media, which is already downloaded. So this is a desktop ISO file. So I am creating a network adapter accordingly to my environment. Yes, so virtual machine is created successfully. Now I am going to start the virtual machine now. So once again I am reminding, make sure that you have enough hard disk space in your host and enough processor cores and enough RAM memory. So now I am going to start the installation. Yes, now the installation type, I am selecting something else as my option. So this will guide to the manual partitioning screen. So here I'm going to create new partition table. So here you can see the free space. So by clicking that plus button, you can start creating the mount points. So first I am creating root as my mount point. So I am allocating 22 GB and this will be the primary partition. So root is created successfully. So again some free space is there. So again I am creating another mount point. So this will be slash home directory. So I am allocating 10 GB to this slash home directory. So all the partitions created here have ext4 file systems. So again some free space is there. So I am going to create slash tmp folder. So I am allocating 10 GB space to slash tmp. Slash tmp is a temporary space for a Linux operating system. So slash tmp created. Now again some free space is there. I am going to create slash usr directory. So slash usr mount point will be having lot of installation folders, so that I am allocating 16 GB to this slash usr directory. So all the system files will be installed in slash usr. So slash usr created successfully. So now I am going to allocate create slash var. Slash var is a variable data where all the log files, system log files are getting stored. So I am allocating 10 GB to that mount point. again some free space. So again I'm going to create one more mount point. So this will be slash SRV. So I'm going to allocate 10 GB to this slash SRV mount point. So slash SRV is created successfully. Again some free space, select that plus button. Now the mount point will be slash USR local. So I am going to allocate 10 GB. So 10 GB is enough for slash USR local. Now I am going to create another mount point in a free space. So this will be slash OPT. Slash OPT I am going to use as my third party software installation. So all my third party software installation will be in slash OPT folder. So I am allocating 25 GB to slash OPT folder. Now I am going to create a swap space. So here I am going to allocate a huge space for swap, because I am going to use memory hungry applications. So it will require more swap space in future. So I am allocating 26 GB to my swap partition. So swap partition is a virtual memory for a Linux operating system. So if RAM is get filled, Linux will be using swap partition. So again some free space is there. So here I am going to create manually one directory. So it will be slash softwares. So this slash softwares will be acting as my storage space, storage area to my binaries. So I'm allocating 22 GB to this mount point. So remaining space I will be allocating to log files. So log files, so slash log files is slash log files. I am going to allocate remaining space. So it was created successfully. And make a note that I have not created mount point for boot files. So boot files will be automatically get installed in slash in root partition in virtualized environment. So this is a virtualized environment. We no need to worry about the root partition. So before you create the partition, review it and click the install button. Now I am selecting the time zone keyboard layout and create the login user to this virtual machine. One more thing, Ubuntu 14.04 has support until 2019. So only we are demonstrating how to create manual partition in Ubuntu 14.04. Still many users in the across the world are using Ubuntu 14.04. So now installation was completed. So I'm going to restart the virtual machine. So booted successfully. So now I am going to log in to verify whether all the directories or mount point created successfully with allocated spaces. Make sure that you have enough hard disk in your host machine and memory and enough processor core. So here I am going to system settings. So details button will give you a basic information. Here you can see 15 GB memory, processor core, 6 cores got allocated successfully. So now I am going to verify the mount points. So I am going to verify each directory by right click in the directory. So first I am right click the home directory. Right click properties. So it will give some details. So here free space you can see in 9.2 GB. So in during installation I allocated 10 GB to home directory. Slash OPT 23.2 GB. Slash root I allocated 22 GB during installation. So slash TMP, yes, 9.2 GB. Slash var, yes. So I can able to see that all the mount points created successfully with that space which I have allocated. So we can verify the mount point in many ways. So for clarity, I am verifying each and every folder in GUI for your clarity. So I am going to verify in terminal, in command line, I am going to verify. First, I am going to verify the disk space by issuing df-kh command. So this will list down all the mount points. Now I am going to check the amount of memory installed on swap space by issuing free-m commands. Here you can see memory and swap space created successfully. So manual partitioning of hard disk in Ubuntu 14.04 is successful. So once again I am going to verify in using disk utility. So I am going to search disk utility. Yes, this disk utility give you the details about the partitions. So by clicking on each partition mount point, you can see the device assigned and space and contents, everything. So you can see that home directory mounted at home slash temp slash user usr slash var slash srv slash usr local slash opt so slash softwares. So custom layout and manual partitioning is successful. Subscribe our YouTube channel Java FRM for more videos.